After taking apart the Baseus charger and power bank, then we got a power strip from Baseus today. It adopts GaN technology, and you can charge up to 6 devices at a time through the AC and DC outlets. So let's start today's video. The product and its name are printed on the front. Flip to the back, we can see a usage scenario and specs info below it. Open the box and take it out. It contains some cartoon stickers, documents, and the power strip itself. Remove the plastic bag. It adopts rectangular design and the power cord is not detachable, and is wrapped with a layer of plastic film. Tear it off. There is a two-prong AC outlet on the top, surrounded by a circle of matte chamfer. The power button and the Baseus logo are at the bottom. The 40W GaN logo and a three-prong outlet are on one side. Another outlet is on the other side. Two USB-C and one USB-A port are set on the front panel with orange color. There is a rubber sleeve at the junction of the power cord and the power strip. Pretty solid. All specs info are printed at the bottom. Model is CCGAN40-3ACS. The rated voltage is 125 volts, and rated current and power can be up to 13 amp and 1625 watts respectively. It has passed FCC and ETL certifications. Baseus logo is on the front of the plug. It adopts US standards and has passed ETL certification. The cable length is about 1.5 meters, and the size of the power strip is about 115 by 46.5 by 42 millimeter. And the weight is about 350 grams. Connect it to the power and press the power button. A circle of ice blue light will light up. Connect it to the ChargerLab Power ZKM002C. It shows the USB-C one supports FCB, AFC, QC3+, PD3.0, and Apple 2.4 amp protocols. And it also supports three fixed videos of 5 volts, 3 amp, 9 volts, 2.22 amp, and 12 volts, 1.67 amp. Switching to USB-C2, we can see the protocols and PDO information of those two ports are exactly the same, so you can use any USB-C port to get the maximum power. And the USB-A supports FCP, AFC, QC3.0, and Apple 2.4 amp protocols. Next, let's go ahead and take it apart to see how we can support AC and DC outlets at the same time. First, use a spider to pry along the gap. Remove the bottom cover. The internal module consists of independent AC module and USB-DC module, and they are connected by red and black wires. First, take out the USB module. Cut off the wires. The entire module is composed of four different PCBs. And the internal is filled with silicon adhesives to enhance heat dissipation. Then let's separate those four PCBs. This power strip integrates three switching power supply circuits used for fast charging, relay control, and power detection respectively. Two of them adopt the high-frequency QR flatback topology with wide voltage output. This small PCB at the input end is used to detect voltage, current, and control the circuit. It integrates current sampling resistor, sampling chip, and relay. Flip to the back, this is the fuse, insulated in heat shrinkable tube. The safety extra capacitor is from KWOKTRAN, 0.1 microfarad. And the bridge rectifier is from PINGWEI, 1 amp, 1000 volts. Two identical filter capacitors are from CapXon, 4.7 microfarad, 400 volts. And the other capacitor is the same. The non-isolated buck converter is from Li Semi, which integrates a 750 volts MOSFET. The output current can be up to 150 milliamp, and the fixed voltage is 5 volts. This green output filter capacitor is 10 volts, 220 microfarad. The energy metering IC is on the back and from Hiliwi, which is used to measure the AC voltage and output current. And this is the current sense resistor, 1 milliohm. The relay is from HONGFA, which controls the power supply of the AC part. The contact current is 16 amp and the coil voltage is 5 volts. This is another small control PCB used to detect overvoltage, overcurrent, and control the power button. It integrates LED indicator lights, switching power supply and MCU, etc. The buck chip comes from Bright Power Semiconductor and adopts SOP7 package. It's a switching power supply chip controlled by the primary side. An optocoupler is used for charging status feedback. The SMDY capacitor is from TRX. And this Schottky diode is used for output rectification. The solid capacitor for output filtering is from CapXon, 330 microfarad, 6.3 volts. This is a spring under the power button. A chip for touch detection is next to it. A circle of LED indicators around the spring can indicate the working status. The MCU is used for overvoltage, overcurrent protection, and detection. Next, move to another small PCB for USB fast charging, directly connected to the AC input. This is the input time delay fuse, 3.15 amp, 250 volts. The blue varistor is used for input surge protection. Here is the safety extra capacitor and common mode choke. The bridge rectifier is also from PINGWEI, 3 amp, 1000 volts. Those three high voltage filter capacitors are from BERYL, 400 volts, 22 microfarad. The differential mode choke is wound with magnet wires and insulated by heat shrinkable tube. Another high voltage filter capacitor is from Yongming, 50 microfarad, 400 volts. The mass control chip is from MERAKI, which is a QR flyback PWM controller and optimized for PD fast charging. The GaN power transistor is from Innoscience, which features high frequency efficiency, extremely low loss, and fast active cooling. It also adopts DFN 5x6 package for a smaller size charger, 650 volts, 480 milliohm. Another mass control chip is also from MERAKI, which integrates MOSFET and is also optimized for PD fast charging. This is the transformer, and the SMDY capacitor is also from TRX. Two optocouplers are used for output voltage feedback and regulation of two circuits. Two solid capacitors are from Yongming, corresponding to two switch power supply circuits, 680 microfarad, 16 volts. The last small PCB is used for output, equipped with two protocol chips, three USB connectors, and corresponding VBUS MOSFETs. The USB PD protocol chip is from Jadad and adopts SOP-8 package. It has high performance, high compatibility, and can support multiple fast charging protocols. The VBUS MOSFET for USB-C is from Advent and adopts PBAK 3x3 package, 30 volts, 5.7 milliohm. The other protocol chip is from Win Semiconductor, which controls a USB-C and a USB-A board. It has passed the USB PD 3.0 certification and can support multiple fast charging protocols. The VBUS MOSFET for USB-A is from Alepec Semi and adopts PDFN 3030 package, 30 volts, 8.5 milliohm. Well, that's all components of this Baseus PowerCombo 6-in-1 GaN power chip. After taking it apart, we found the internal module could be divided into four different parts. The AC module and USB fast charging module are independent, but they are tightly combined and stacked together, making the charger size even smaller. Okay, that's all for today's video. Feel free to click the corners to check the teardown of other power strips. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!